Hey guys, in this video, I want to go over a population genetics problem, I guess I'm going to call it. And this is based on some work that I've been doing for the past couple of weeks for a project, because actually there are some statistical methods to solving this problem. But I think I want to make a couple of different videos on this, or else the video will get too long. So this is going to be the first video on this subject. And I kind of want to introduce the problem, which I'm definitely not a biologist, so I'm just going to try to introduce it the best way I can. And I'm going to go over the first original solution to this problem, which today is called the Bernstein method, based on a paper he published in 1925. I'm going to go over his method of solving this problem in this video. So, trying to describe this genetic problem, this is based on blood typing. So, humans have different blood types based on the DNA makeup of your red blood cells. And today, the most common method of blood typing is called the ABO blood type. And it's actually based on this method that Bernstein discovered, or basically, he proved that this was the correct genetic inheritance. So, today, with modern technology, you can get your DNA genotyped and you can find out exactly what genes and whether you have a dominant or recessive allele for your blood, for example. So, you can figure this out exactly, but even today that's expensive and most people are not going to do that type of blood test. So the more common type of blood test is based on observed phenotype instead of actually getting your DNA genotyped. So the way people do blood testing is there are things called A antigens on your red blood cells and B antigens. Based on your blood type, your blood can react to the A antigen, the B antigen, both antigens, or neither. And based on how your blood reacts to these antigens, you can be four different phenotypes, which is different from, again, your genotypes, but we'll get to that in a minute. You can have blood type A, B, AB, or O. This is based on an inheritance pattern where you have three different alleles for your blood. You can have A, B, or O, and then the A and B alleles are both dominant over O. So if you have A, it will be dominant and you'll have blood type A. If you have B, it will be dominant over O. So if you have blood type O, it means you have two recessive alleles. So if you have phenotype A, you can be either AA because you inherit one allele from your mother, inherit one allele from your father, or you can be AO because even just having one allele will show dominance and you'll still react to the A antigen. Same thing with B, you could be BB or BO genotypically, but phenotypically you'll be observed as having blood type B. So this is a system that we know that humans have today, but back in the day, people were not sure of the inheritance pattern or how people have different blood types. We knew that we had different blood types, but we weren't sure if this was based on multiple allele inheritance at different loci. So the alternative hypothesis was that there were two A alleles, the dominant allele, capital A, or the recessive one, lowercase a, and then on a separate loci, you could have another gene with two allele inheritances. So it's like two alleles for two different genes. That was the alternative hypothesis. And that would give you a bunch of other inheritance patterns. So people thought, okay, maybe you could have like uppercase A, uppercase B, lowercase B, and that type of inheritance pattern, which is completely different from the ABO blood type, which assumes three alleles. So this assumed two alleles on two different locations. So the question was, okay, which hypothesis is right? And Bernstein came up with a proof for this based on observed phenotypes. So the problem was that we don't know the true underlying DNA genotypes. We only observe the phenotypes, and some are dominant and some are recessive. So based on observed phenotypes, how do you estimate the underlying genotypic frequencies is kind of like the statistical problem. So let's go ahead and go into Bernstein's method of proving that the ABO blood type was the correct way based on observed phenotypes. Okay, so we have to also talk about, I spelled this wrong, Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. So Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium basically says that you know an equation for the expected genotypic frequencies of the blood, making certain assumptions in your population. So when you assume Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, you assume that there's no selective preference in the environment for one allele over the other. So you're assuming that there's no advantage which this is a safe assumption to make for healthy people, there's no advantage of being blood type A, B, AB, or O. It doesn't really matter. That's not something you would really know unless you get your blood tests done. So under Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, there are well-known equations for the expected genotypic frequencies. Using the ABO blood type model, let's say P stands for the expected frequency of allele A, so that P is equal to PA. Let's say Q is equal to the allele frequencies for blood type B. And then let's say R is equal to the expected genotypic frequencies of blood type O. Then under Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, this is going to be a trinomial expansion. So this is going to be P plus Q plus R squared. And that gives you formulas for the expected frequencies. So you're going to have P squared plus Q squared plus R squared plus 2PQ plus 2PR plus 2QR. So under the ABO blood typing system, you have six possible genotypes. You can be AA, AO, BB, BO, AB, or OO. And then you're going to be one of those six genotypes based on the following expected frequency counts. So for AA, the expected genotypic frequency count would be PA squared. For AO, it would be 2PA, PO. For BB, it would be PB squared. For BO, it would be 2PB, PO. For AB, it would be PA, PO. And for OO, it would be PO squared. So those would be the expected frequency counts genotypically. And we're saying that the problem is for this type of equations is that we do not observe the genotypes directly. We observe, instead of six genotypes, we observe one of four phenotypes. So we observe blood type A, B, AB, or O based on those antigen blood tests that are much more common than being DNA genotyped. So, under Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, we expect to observe the A phenotype with frequency count PA squared plus 2PAPO. So basically, if you're A phenotype, you could be AA or AO. For B, you could be BB or BO. For AB, you still would just observe that directly. And for phenotype O, you still would just observe that directly as well. So these are the genotypes which we do not observe directly, and these are the four phenotypes which we can observe directly with blood tests. And the problem that we want to solve is we basically want to estimate the allele frequencies. So we want to estimate the genetic frequency of allele A, the frequency of allele B, and the genetic frequency of allele O. So let's go over how you would solve this problem. The first method I'm going to use to solve this problem is going to be Bernstein's method that he used without any genotypic information. And I'm going to go over how he solved it, or the equations that he created, based on sample data from this paper. And I'll put the link to this paper in the description box below. So the reason I used this sample data was because actually they did genotype the blood type of people in this data set. So I'm going to calculate expected frequencies that you would expect under Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, and then I'm going to compare them and basically prove that the method works by comparing them to the observed genotypic frequency counts in this paper. So this paper did actually DNA test the red blood cells to get the exact allele frequencies. So I can compare my expected frequencies to observed frequencies if I use this sample data. Okay, so going back to the problem, the sample data set that I'm using observed the following blood phenotypes. So of 1,583 people sampled, 642 had blood type A, 195 had blood type B, 89 had blood type AB, and 657 had blood type O. So this is the type of information you would get. You would get phenotypes, and you want to estimate the underlying genotypic allele frequencies. But it's kind of like missing data, so it's not something you can observe directly. So let's go over the Bernstein equations, which is one method of solving this problem. going back to the difference between the genotypes and the phenotypes, we observe one of four phenotypes for each person. And you see that you cannot directly observe the genotypes for people who have dominant alleles. So if you have phenotype A, you don't know if you are AA or AO. Same thing for B. However, if you are AB, that means that your underlying genotype is AB. And if you are blood type O, because O is a recessive allele, if you are blood type O, that means that both your alleles have to be OO. So if you observe the phenotype O, since it's recessive, you do know your underlying genotype, and that has to be OO because it's the recessive allele. So using that information, one way that you can estimate the genetic frequency of allele O is that you can say that that's equal to the square root of PO squared, which is equal to the square root of observing the phenotype O, which you do observe in a population. So in this population, the total sample size again was 1583. So the phenotypic frequency for being blood type O was 657 divided by 1583. And if you take the square root of that, you'll get the underlying genetic frequency. So if you do 657 divided by 1583, that'll give you 0.41503. And then if you take the square root of that, you get 0.644. So using Bernstein's method, that would be his estimated genotypic frequency for allele O. Then for PA and PB, we're going to basically use the same idea for both. We're going to use the equation PA plus PB plus PO has to equal to 1. So if there are only three possible alleles, the expected frequencies of each one have to sum to 1. And doing PB first, the allele counts of PB has to equal 1 minus the allele counts of A and B. So again, we don't observe this directly, but we can think of this as 1 minus the square root of PA squared plus 2PAPO plus PO squared. So this would be 1 minus the square root of all the allelic frequencies that do not contain PB. And this is equivalent to saying 1 minus PA squared plus 2PAPO. That's equal to the expected phenotypic frequency of being blood type A. So that's going to be 1 minus the phenotype A plus PO squared is the expected phenotypic frequency of being blood type O. So that's going to be phenotype O. So we can think of PB as being estimated by 1 minus the square root of being phenotype A plus phenotype O. So in this problem, that would be 1 minus the square root of 0.055 plus 0.41503. And that would give an estimated allele frequency for B to be 0.94. And we're going to do basically the same thing to estimate the allele frequency of A. So PA hat is going to be 1 minus the square root of observing phenotype B plus observing phenotype O. And for this sample data set, that's going to be 1 minus 195 over 1583 plus 657 divided by 1583, which gives a final estimate for the allelic frequency to be 0.266. So using these Bernstein equations and assuming Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, we can estimate the underlying genotypic frequencies to be 0.644 for PO, 0.094 for PB or allele B, and 0.266 for allele A. And basically what Bernstein did was he calculated these expected frequencies using these two hypotheses. So you could also apply Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium to this alternative hypothesis and get different expected frequencies. And basically he found that the expected frequencies under the three allele hypothesis fit the data a lot better than the alternative hypothesis. So that's how the idea of having an ABO blood type was first confirmed. And just to compare this to the observed frequency counts in the sample data set, the true observed values as discussed in the paper were as follows. For PO or allele O, it was 0.638 was observed. For allele A, it was 0.268. And for allele B, it was 0.095. So these were the true genotyped allele frequency counts. And if we compare our values, our estimated PO is 0.644, whereas the observed was 0.638. For PA, our estimated value is 0.266, whereas the true observed value is 0.268. And for allele B, we estimated it to be 0.094, whereas the true observed frequency was 0.095. So the observed counts do not necessarily have to be the same as the expected frequency counts, but they should be very similar under Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. So this basically proves that this method of determining the underlying genotypic frequencies works. And this is one method. I think I'm going to make a couple of videos on other more statistically advanced methods of solving this problem in future videos. But that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.